Hello everyone, today we're going to take a look at the new and improved chain strings too. If you don't know what chain strings is, it's a script written for Fusion or DaVinci Resolve Fusion. It's basically a search and replace operation specifically tailored for Fusion. For example, the most common task that chain strings is used for is to search and replace in loader file path. So, for example, right here I have a couple of loaders all pointing to the same file, only with a different layer enabled. Because this is my background, I also have a foreground layer. And now I could either create new loaders and select the foreground layer individually, or I can copy and paste all these loaders, open chain string, and I'm going to search for background and replace that with foreground. I'm going to make sure that loaders is enabled, and I'm going to hit OK. Now all the background is replaced with foreground and I'm done. Now that you know what chain strings is, let's take a look at all the new features. The biggest change was actually done under the hood. For you as a user, it's probably that it's now possible to search and replace in strings that have spaces. Because in previous versions of chain strings, the space was always used to split strings into different parts. By default, this is now off. If you don't know what any of that meant, I'm going to explain it at a later point, but for now, all you need to know is that what you see is what you get. So, what else is new? First, the search and replace text inputs are now dropdowns, showing you your previous searches and your previous replace inputs. You can either select them by clicking, or if you type, it will try to autocomplete it, and you can use that if you want. There's now a dedicated clear button. This clear button will remove your input, or if you've accidentally deleted your input, you can hold shift and click on the same button to recover your input. Going further down, you will see that we now have three different tabs: Flow Tools, Versioning, and Text Box. Flow Tools houses all the previous checkboxes and settings that made chain strings one good. Here you can still decide where and what you want to have searched and replaced. So let's take a look at versioning. Versioning is designed to make the version increases or decreases more comfortable. So previously you would have searched for version 1 and replaced that with version 2. But this could get tedious. So now you can easily increase or decrease your versions by selecting the loaders you want and hitting increase. As you've seen, version 1 changed to version 2. And of course we can go back as well. Please note that this requires having a V prefixed to your version number, otherwise it would be too difficult to find out which part of your string is the version number. Next, let's take a look at the text box. The text box is meant to be used for text that you might have in your clipboard, that you found outside of Fusion, or maybe in text inputs that aren't supported right now, for example the custom tool. In the future, I might add another tab for the custom tools, but that really depends on how much people actually need or want that. So let's get back to the text box and how to use it. Right here, I have a text that I want to replace something in. I'm just going to select it and paste it right here, either using the keyboard, or I can also use the on-screen button for that. And I want to change N4 to N2. So I'm going to search for N4. And I'm going to replace it with N2. Now I'm going to hit OK, and now I have my updated text right here. I can either select it and copy it, or I can also just use the copy button right here. And now paste it wherever I want. And of course, the UI is also designed with accidental clicks in mind. For example, you might have a text like this, and now you've accidentally pasted. You can recover your previous input by hitting shift and recover. Even if you have something in your clipboard, like hello, for example, and you accidentally hit the copy button, so now you accidentally have this copied in your clipboard, you can still hit shift and recover your previous clipboard entry. Now let's take a look at the changes for the QuickSelect buttons. The QuickSelect buttons are designed to make it easy for you if you want to search in all loaders, for example, because by default, chain strings will only search in the selected tools. If you want to search all loaders, you can hit Loaders and it will select all your loaders in your scene. This works also for savers, FBX and Alembic nodes, or select loader and saver at once. Something that is new is the new Search QuickSelect button. This allows you to search in a node's name. For example, right here I have a couple of text plus nodes. And maybe I only want to select all the nodes that are called title. Of course, in this case, I could easily select them myself. But just to show you how it works, I'm going to search for title and I'm going to hit search. Now they're all selected. And a big new feature that was added to the QuickSelect buttons is that you can now add and remove tools from your selection. For example, if I now want all my loaders selected as well, I can hit the Shift button and add my loaders to the selection. As mentioned before, this can also remove. So if I hit Control, and I can remove loaders from my selection. The inspector will not always update correctly, but that doesn't matter. It's important what's selected in the flow right here. And these are all of the new big features of Chain Strings 2. There are also a couple of other changes, just to make using it a little bit easier. For example, you will only tap between the two text inputs. This should make it faster for you to quickly type in what you want. Then there is also a new notification label, which you might have seen already. This will tell you what Chain Strings is currently doing and will make sure that you know if it's still searching and replacing. In Chain Strings 1, the only way to know if it's still doing something is to see if the names or the file path in your inspector were changing. So for example, if I have a lot of tools right here, and I want to change the name from subtext to main text, so I'm going to search for sub and I'm going to replace with main. And I'm going to choose names. Now you can see that we have a progress notification telling us that it's still running and when it's done. Tooltips have also been added to pretty much every UI element to explain how and what they're doing, like the shift or control clicking of certain buttons. And of course, Chain Strings 2 still supports all the advanced features like using shortcodes. For example, right here, I have my text, chain strings 1, 2, and 3, but I want all of these to be chain strings 2. So I'm going to search for percentage %d, which means all digits in Lua, and I'm going to replace that with a 2. I'm going to need to select style text, and I'm going to hit OK. And as you can see, all the numbers have been changed to 2. In other search and replace programs, you would have had to do this individually, searching first for 1 and then for 3. Alright, let's take a look at the space splitter. Activating the space splitter will mean that Chain Strings will split your search and replace inputs by spaces. This allows to switch patterns around or to search and replace several inputs at once. For example, right here I have a text with all new features, all exciting features. I even have a small capitalization error right here. And we want to change features to look the same all the time, and we want to change all to many. Now, we could either put in this text, and this text, and this text, and so on, or we can use the space splitter. So I'm going to search for all, and I'm going to search for features. I've tried it before, so it fills it out. And we're going to replace all with many, and features with a capital features. Let's hit OK. And now we can see that we have changed the first and the third word, but we haven't changed anything in the middle, exactly what we wanted. And because we didn't have case sensitivity on, we have changed all occurrences of the word features. So let's try switching something around. We want to put features at first and many at the back. So I'm going to just hit the switch button to change my inputs. And I'm going to write features and many. Let's hit OK. And we switched it around. You can also change several words into one by simply inputting only one word in your replace input. So let's do just like that and put in features, hit OK. And now we've changed two words at once. And that's everything I wanted to demonstrate today. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments or use the question mark button right here, which will bring you to my website, which will give you a whole manual for chain strings, as well as giving you a table of the different advanced searches or shortcodes, like the digits one we used, or lowercase and uppercase letters, and so on. You can download it today, and the link should be in the description. See ya!